Well, beginning next month, I've learned that St. Paul and Ramsey County will be converting the old detox facility here into an emergency homeless shelter. And as we learned today, they're not waiting for the people to come to them.
St. Paul has seen an increase in a population in areas that are often overlooked until falling leaves expose the issue and concern triggers complaints.
We're with the city, just letting you know. You gotta move on.
St. Paul police and code enforcement are now responding to homeless encampment complaints 2 to 3 times a week, but they often issue warnings instead of making arrests.
We don't really want to be in the business of taking their stuff. These individuals are citizens of St. Paul, and so we're gonna treat them just like we treat anyone else.
And with each warning comes a handout offering help.
You know where People's Inc. is up here, up on the hill?
Well, this is all new to me.
There's a bunch of programs that'll help you, and you can go there during the day. The people that do call in the complaints don't realize that their, you know, shelters are full. That's a constant battle.
Limited space at the nearby gospel mission is why this man named Chris says he reluctantly ended up here with his girlfriend.
That night's kind of scary out here. I mean, I know grown men that won't walk down here.
Police say crime is up, and a recent murder nearby brings even more urgency.
You haven't reached out until now for some resources?
Not really. I just got out of an abusive relationship.
Okay. You're down here by yourself?
Yeah.
When I see something like that's a big red flag for me, that we got to get her inside.
Officers say it's a long process, but one they'll continue.
They weren't mean, rude, or, forceful, She brought help. So, I mean, yeah, I appreciate it.
If I can get one person housed out of 10, and I've done my job, it's a success.
I'm told the emergency shelter will open here in early December, and officers will use it as a drop-off site. One more tool to get people out of the cold in emergencies and hopefully in touch with long-term help. Back to you.
Some nice reporting from Kent Erdahl. Mm-hmm.